Hello, fellow gunners. Tim here at the range. Gonna do some more gas bullet function and accuracy tests today with the M16. This is really not an M16, it's an M15A2 Armalite. I misspoke on my first video using this gun. I've actually got it to function now. It was having trouble with the bolt shutting, but it's working now. Now we're going to try and... Now this is open sights. My eyesight's just gone, so I'm going to try it out and see what happens. Here we go. This is the first load. I don't know. I forgot my paper. So I don't know. I've got five loads with five different powders. And I will put that in the descriptions when I post this video, because right now I don't remember what they are, but I'm going to mark them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go, guys. Did I not pick up? Here we go, test one. Apparently, guys, this gun just does not like my cast bullets. I'm not even going to try it anymore. Tired of it. All right, now we're going to shoot the Mini 14, see what it does. Well, that was my first powder. And we're going to try my... Now, wait a minute. That means I got one more shot, doesn't it? All right, here we go. Yeah, there we go. That was my last shot. Now we're going to try the... Now we're going to try the next powder. This time I'll count my rounds. Okay, guys, so far we're not having a functioning issue in the Mini 14. Not with these loads, okay, with the cast bullets. Right, let's go with number 3 here, see what it does. That functioned really well too. Alright, let's go with the number 4 powder. See how it works. Not a function issue there either. Well, I hope these are printing really well. Then we might have some good loads. Yeah, here we go with number 5. I miscounted somewhere, but they all functioned really well. Now, if we got good groups, we know we got good powder. All right, I'll be back with the targets. All right, guys. One bullet to print, and I don't know if that was from the M16. I think it was, so I didn't get anything to print, so I'm going to have to take some more time. I'm going to have to load some more of those and start at the 25-yard line and get some prints, get something on paper. But now, I'm going to test this new tapco magazine. It's a Gen 2. Got the metal clip up on top. See how it runs through the Mini 14. Should have let that slide a little harder, shouldn't I don't think it's a magazine. Alright, I'm going to clear this and I'll be back. You know what that was? My gun's sluggish. Maybe it's dirty. It didn't take long. It's not coming back all the way for some reason. Maybe it is the mag. I just tried to clip one in. It just real. It's like it's dragging on it or something. That tapco mag might not be worth having. Yeah, let's try it again. Yep. See, it's not ejecting. All right, guys. I'm going to try my factory mag. See if it's going to feed. I've got some Z-Max in here. I need to see if I can get them to print through this scope anyway. I have not adjusted this scope yet for me, and that's the problem. All right, here we go. It must be that Tapco magazine. I'm not saying all Tapco magazines are bad. That might just be one of them. But apparently that one ain't going to function good. I didn't have any flaws with that. You know, putting magazines in this Mini 14 is kind of a pain. Like I said, guys, first the video, I'll put those loads on them first ones, the five different powder charges. I'll put that down in the description, and I'll load some more of them up, and I'll test the accuracy later. I wanted to see if they function. They function good in the Mini 14. The M15A2 is just, I don't know, I'm having problems with it. All right, guys, that concludes this video. Hey, thanks for watching. See you in the next, or catch you in the next video.